Hello students, welcome back to my channel. In our last lecture we were discussing about standard 12 computer subject chapter number 3 designing simple website using composer, and we completed our home page and other pages. Now today we will talk about how to generate shopping cart. Okay. And for that purpose we prepared one purchase button, and in our site if somebody click on this purchase button, then we prepare a script that it will go to function on cart, means it comes here and then it follows all the sentences. Now before we start the script, I would like to clarify that we select three products on the home page, and in my previous lecture I already clarified that the ID of this checkbox and text box is very important. So as a part of revision, the ID of the checkbox and ID of the text box, that is respectively B1 and Q1, I mean to say the ID of this first checkbox is B1, then B2, then B3, and the ID of this text box, according to textbook, it is Q1. So here it is Q1, Q2 and Q3. Now in this notepad we will do the rough work to understand the script, and here we will go for the script. We select three products, so I took a tick mark for three products and I click on purchase button, so it go to the function on cart. Here we have a variable whose name is check and its value is false. So here in rough work I will write check is equal to false. Then another variable, cookie value, is equal to double quotes two times. Double quotes two times means blank. So it says like this, double quotes two times is blank, okay. Now we go for a first if condition. Now this particular word get element by ID is case sensitive, means whenever you use this in exam you need to be very careful, because element E, B and I, they must be capital. It must be as it is, the way how it right now in front of your eyes, get element by ID. What we are checking, B1 dot checked, the element ID B1 is checked. Document means the screen. Get the element by ID B1. First of all we have to go to the ID B1. This is the ID B1. What we are saying is checked. In reality it is checked, so condition is true. True means it will go inside the bracket, where the value of check is now become true, which was false, now it become true. VAR quantity, so we create one more variable, that is quantity. Now what is the value of quantity? Document dot get element by ID Q1 dot value. This is document, that is Q1 ID, and the value is 1. So take the value of this ID Q1 and assign as a value of variable quantity. So here the value of variable quantity is 1. Now the next is value of variable price is 399. So value of variable price is 399. Total is equal to price into quantity. So this is, we have a total price 399 into quantity 1. So the answer is 399. Next sentence is very important. Okay. The sentence says cookie value plus equal to. Okay, so I will write the sentence, otherwise it will be a bit complicated for you to understand. So The sentence is cookie value plus equal to cookie value plus equal to colon girl's pink bag plus price plus plus quantity comma and total. Now how to simplify this? When it mentioned plus equal to, I am just giving you a shortcut technique. When it is mentioned plus equal to, select the first word cookie value and write cookie value is equal to cookie value as it is. I repeat, the first word is cookie value, so write cookie value is equal to cookie value. Then what is left? Plus symbol is left, so put plus. Then in double quotes, what is mentioned? Now here plus will join all these things. So in double quotes, it's mentioned colon girl's pink bag comma. Now price means here the value of price is 399. So you have to write down 399 comma. Okay, quantity, that is 1 comma total 399. Now if you simplify this, the value of variable cookie value which was blank, I hope you notice this. So here what happened, it will replace with blank. Now in blank if you add all this, then what happened? The next value of variable cookie value will be this. Old value will remove and new value is cookie value is equal to double quotes colon girls pink bag comma 399 comma 1 comma 399. Okay, always remember when any variable get the new value, its old value is replaced. Okay, now we will go ahead. Remember, this is the latest value of variable cookie value. Okay, now after that we have one more if condition. See, document dot get element by id b2 is checked. We'll compare. Yes, B2 ID is check, condition is true. So it go inside this bracket of if condition. Again the value of check is true. The value of variable check is true. Quantity is equal to document dot get element by ID Q2 dot value. So this is Q2, ID Q2 and its value is 1. So this value is assigned to variable quantity. So the value of variable quantity is 1. Then the price is 410 and price into quantity. So we'll write in rough work, price is 410 and total is what? Price into quantity. Price into quantity means 410 into 1. So answer is 410. Now here majority students make mistake. See, again cookie value plus equal to, we will write the sentence cookie value, then it mention plus equal to colon. Now don't worry about why colon available, the colon is very helpful and comma is also very helpful for the next script. Boys blue bag comma price comma quantity comma total. Okay, now we simplify this. How I explain you? First word is cookie value. So cookie value is equal to cookie value, okay, plus double quotes join everything, colon boys blue bag comma price means 410 comma quantity is 1 comma total is 410. Now if you see carefully, here what is mentioned? Cookie value is equal to cookie value. Now what do you mean by this? This cookie value which is right hand side of equal to will pick up old value. Old value is this one. This is old value. Now old value is replaced over here. So now what happened? Old value will join with new value. So now the latest value of variable cookie value is its old value plus added new value, so it become like this. So now the latest value of variable cookie value is colon girls pink bag, 399, 1, 399, colon boys blue bag, 410, 1, 410. Okay. Then next, after that we go for third if condition. If document.get element by ID B3 is checked, in reality is also ID B3 is checked. So condition becomes true. So it go inside, value of variable check is true. So we will put true over here. Then quantity is equal to document.get element by ID Q3.value. So here this is the Q3 and value is 1. So with that logic, quantity, value of variable quantity is 1, price is 500, and total is equal to 500 into quantity, means 500 into 1. So the total is 500. Now next is cookie value plus equal to colon beam bag plus price plus quantity plus total. Now how to simplify? As I told you, cookie value is equal to cookie value plus, we need to write down, colon beam bag comma price means 500 comma 1 comma 500. Now at this variable cookie value we will replace the old value. The old value is this one. This old value is replaced over here. Okay, and old value join with new value because plus is used to join. So now the new value is like this, and old value is over. So this is the way how it works. Okay, if you notice, every time we are joining the cookie value. Okay, now likewise manner, students, it go for another ID NB1, CP1, P1, which we not create, but it will check the same way. The same way it will check till the last if. Now last if is very important, very 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 important, because it asks an exam also. See the condition. If exclamatory check, we will write in our rough work. If exclamatory check. Now what do you mean by this? The value of check is what? True. So if exclamatory true. Now students, be careful. Exclamatory stands for not. So not true, how you speak this? Not true. Not true means false. False means skip the bracket and go to else part. Okay, I repeat what I say. The condition is, if exclamatory means not check, the value of variable check in our rough work is true. So this value we will put over here at the place of check. So if exclamatory means not and true. So if not true means false. In the case of false, it will skip the bracket and go to else part. And in else part it is mentioned document.cookie. Students, this is very important. Document.cookie, this is very special part of your browser. All your passwords and item which you are surfing and all those, they are stored in your browser in the cookie area. So document.cookie is a part of a computer system. And what it will be stored in the part of computer system? Document.cookie is equal to cookie value. Now cookie value means all this is now the value of document.cookie. Remember, document.cookie is a special part of your operating system or your browser, we can say, and there it will normally store the passwords and all what you write recently surf on the website, and your choice and wish list, everything is stored as document.cookie. So here what we are saying, we are saying that whatever the value of variable cookie value, that will be the value of document.cookie. So here it go for document.cookie and then this is the value. Okay, even though you shut down your computer, it will remember what you store as document.cookie. Then it's mentioned window.location. Window means your browser window. Dot location means open. Open your browser window. And then which file need to be open? build.html. So here we have a build.html. This is build.html. And this build.html is absolutely on the basis of these four lines. I strongly insist that you note down these four lines in your book, because on the basis of this four line, on the basis of these four lines, we will discuss the next script, that is billing script. In textbook it is not explained, but I want to explain you, because questions can be asked from anywhere. Okay, so this sentence is, you can pause the video and you can note down, you can write down somewhere in your book, because on the basis of this document.cookie we need to learn the next script. Now in this script, suppose we go for a different condition. I will again revise the script with a different situation. Look at this. I not tick mark anything. Okay, and I click on purchase. So again it go for the script beginning part. So here the script start. Here we go for a new rough work. Be careful, I again run the whole script. No tick mark, I click on purchase button, so it go to the on cart, create variable check with the value false, and cookie value is equal to blank. Then all b1.check, element id b1.check is dot checked, but reality it is not checked. Look at this, we are saying it is checked, but in reality it is not checked, so it become false. So it will skip this bracket, it will go for next b2 id b2 is checked, but reality it is not checked, so it will skip that one also. Id b3 is checked, but in reality it is not checked, so it will skip. Likewise manner, it will go to the last if statement. What is the last if statement? If not check. Look at this. If not check means value of check is what? False. If exclamatory means not, false means true. True means it go inside the bracket and show the alert. What is the alert? No item selected. And reality also no items are selected. So this is the way how script will work. The script which I require to explain you for 15 to 20 minutes, see what is given in textbook. Only informative part is given, interactive part is not mentioned. As seen in code listing 3.1, which is this one, we have a function onCart, and the first if statement block check whether the checkbox for the item 1 is checked or not. Earlier we have given the ID name b1 to checkbox of item 1. Using document.getElementById b1.check, we will check whether the user has checked the item. And if it is checked, then we will save the quantity into a variable and calculate the total price. And we finally save the product name, price, quantity and amount as a string in a variable. This is called string. Whatever you mention in double quotes, this is called string. We store all the items, it price, quantity and total as a string in a variable. Which variable? The variable was cookie value. We finally save the product name, price, quantity and amount as a variable. Each of the details are separate with delimiter comma. Can be asked in exam, please underline. And individual product description is separate with the colon symbol, and the script continues for each item listed. Now these two paragraphs are important, so please tick mark everything, especially from this paragraph in all the board exams MCQs ask. So please note down and underline it properly according to new marking scheme. This chapter has very high marks. So I request you to take chapter 2 very seriously, because it will be boosting you, your mark sheet, in terms of scoring and all those. Next, we have to go for reading part. If the user has not selected any of the items, then pressing the purchase button will show the message no item selected, as I explained you. Otherwise, the items are saved as cookie. Now, you must have a question, why sir is speaking about cookie? Cookie, what is cookie? Underline, cookie is a variable that is stored on user's computer or your mobile phone. Those who are using mobile phone, in their browser there is an option called clear cookie. So that is the area what they are talking about. So cookie is a variable that is stored on user's computer. Important sentence. They are useful as they provide features to remember and take preferences, purchases, commissions and other information required for better visitor experience or site statistics. Like for example, if I am searching about mobile phone constantly in Amazon, then in Amazon cookie they will note down that I am searching about iPhone mobile. So whenever I open Amazon, they will show me the offer of iPhone only. That is called cookie. Another way is to track your experience. Few of you, if you notice that if you search something on Amazon and then you go to your Instagram, then you will come to know that Instagram will show you what you surf on Amazon. So JavaScript can manipulate cookies using cookie property. Underline, important, cookie property of document object. This line asked in board exam so many times. Cookie property of document object. How we say that? Because we learned that the word before dot is known as object and the word after dot is known as either property or function. So in that context they are saying that cookie property of document object. Then cookie can be read, create, modify and deleted. Underline, important, at the cookie area of your computer or mobile, you can read the information, can create the information, you can modify the information and you can delete the information. Now when the user clicks on the purchase button, the script calls the web page build.html. So it will move on the build.html page. This is build.html. And the JavaScript in build.html will calculate the total of all the items selected along with the total amount to be paid. So it calculates total items and it calculates total amount to be paid. And here we have a code listing 3.2 shows the JavaScript that calculates the total amount. So this is, we'll understand as total amount. You know, when you purchase online, you can able to see your final bill. That comes with the help of these kind of script. But before this kind of script, we have to learn the concept of looping and array. So I will explain the term looping and array first, and then I will explain you the process of this billing script. Okay. And here we have prepared a function called myFun, and this function is accepting the data from cookie. Now accepting data from cookie means what? It accepting data from cookie means this cookie. Okay. And store it into the array. Now I will not continue from here because I want to explain you what is array, and I also want to explain you about the function called pairs float. Okay, so I will conclude my lecture over here, but before I complete the lecture, I request you to note down these four lines in your book, because next whatever we learn, that will be on the basis of this. Okay. Please be careful about double quotes and colon and comma, because it matters a lot in our next script. Okay, so I will complete my lecture over here. If you have any suggestions, any query, you can ask in comment section. Till then, please take care of yourself, students. God bless you. Thanks.